Gbenga Adeyinka is first and foremost a Nigerian, a family man. I'm not just a Nigerian. I'm passionately, unrepentantly, I'm a stubborn Nigerian, very, very tenacious. I don't let go easy. And I try to make a living by making people laugh and by comparing events and by being on TV and by generally just hustling for money. I'm sure the reason my mother gave birth to me was because I gave her too much problems in her stomach and she had to push me out in a jiffy. I realized I wanted to be on the stage when I was in Form 3. We had a stage production called The Gods Are Not to Blame by Olarotimi. It was a theater workshop thing and I felt so alive, I felt so happy. I'd always like to be the center of attraction, make people laugh, disturb people in class, tell jokes. Luckily, I also went to Unilag, got involved in a theater troupe called Theater 15. I did a lot of stage productions. People would invite me to do their end of year dinners, their whole thingies and all that. And at the end of the day, when I graduated, people would call me and say, oh, I need you to anchor our end of year party or anchor my wedding. And I didn't know they were getting paid until somebody said, come, and you know, how much do you charge? I said, eh? Money day? Ah, okay. Let's take this thing professional. I met Ali at a function I did. And he said, what do you do? I said, I work in a construction firm. He said, oh, I want you to be, you should be a comedian. I said, God forbid. I pushed it forward. And if I'd known, I would have pushed it back. And I met it a couple of years down the line. But when did I know? I think I've always known, I was just not brave enough to do it. For me, stand-up is like a drug. I get high. It's an opportunity to do what I've always wanted to do. So for me, I just release and I will have done a little preparation and every other thing just goes. For me, it's the highest form of release. That's why I don't do drugs at all. My mainstay when I first started were weddings. And the bride would have come across you somewhere, or maybe the mother of the bride would have come across you somewhere. And by the time they book you, they call back and say, oh, my daddy has booked Alibaba, I'm sorry. Or my daddy has booked Okay Bakasi, I'm sorry. And it took a while, but like I said, I'm very tenacious. My philosophy in life is keep hitting your head on the wall. It will give way. So I knew it was just a matter of time. The turning point in my career was something I did for my friend TA. He sent me outside Lagos to do an event for him. I finished the event and this guy said, wow, where have you been? You know what, keep calling me, and I kept calling him. And one day he said, I have a gig for you. I don't know if I can mention brand. Said, I have a gig for you for staff. And I said, oh, okay. So we went round, we did three cities, and they were having a quest to pick a band, pick a musical group. After I finished the three gig, the MD of Nigerian Breweries was there. He said, ah, congrats, that was a good one. See you in the next city. I said, no, sir, this is my last one. He said, no, you do everything. So I was all over Nigeria, 36 states. I was in people's houses without them even inviting me. And that for me was, I think, what gave me my break. Laugh matters, wala day. You know, when I first started, I also knew that for me to get mileage, I had to be on TV. It was my friend's sister that said, Ukubing, everybody is having TA just had a show at Muslim Center. And you know, she show come now. So I decided, okay, let's have a show. I invited everybody. And it was not profitable. We had more artists than we had a paying audience. But at the end of the day, I enjoyed it. And I said, well, once we started, we can't let go. So we did about 5 editions in Lagos. I spent a part of my life in Ibadan. And I grew up on the works of Baba Salah, Baba Mero, Ajimaja Shon, all the greats. They were all over TV when I was in Ibadan growing up. And something hit me one day at an event in Lagos. A Yoruba boy said, you know, we worry people. In worry where we're from, where comedy really started from. And I felt really bad. And I said, you know what? What's the use of feeling bad if you can't do anything about it? Why don't you try to develop another generation of comedians in the Southwest that would match them Baba Salah, Baba Mero, and all that, so that we'll know that we have a pedigree. So we started Laugh Matters concert in Ibadan. It was a mad year. The first show was sold out, and we've not looked back since then. We've done Ibadan like 5 times. We've done Oshogbo twice. We just finished Abeokuta recently. Next year, we hope to do more cities. People have been asking me, do this show in Lagos, and I tell them, that is not my brief. My brief is to develop more superstars in the Southwest, outside Lagos. And you'll be surprised how many people come to these shows. You'll be surprised how many talents we have out there. There's a young man called Peteru. There's another guy called Laugh Up. There's so many people out there, Wole Arole the Prophet, so many people just looking for a platform to blow. And that's the gospel I'm running with now. Unfortunately, I get inspired by too many people in different fields of life. My role models are Martin Luther King Jr., who says that if you have a dream, anything is possible. Chief Nkyo Adeola, who says if you come from anywhere in Nigeria, you can be loved by all. So many people in different fields of life. Alibaba, Bill Cosby, quite a lot of them. But everybody I come across, I try to pick something meaningful from. I'd like to be remembered as that guy who God gave little talents, blew it up, affected other people positively, and whose name will never be forgotten. One thing I wish I knew then is, no matter what anybody says, keep going. Don't let anybody hold you down. Once you convince yourself this is what you want to do, back there, not in the apple. Let's keep going. Bow. Kai sanunko jama, sunana Gbenga Adeyinka sedikin dayani. If you don't speak Hausa, ndewo afambu. Gbenga Adeyinka one. If you don't speak Igbo or Bokeh, if you don't speak that, it doesn't matter. My name is Gbenga Adeyinka the first. And you know what? I'm a Maverick.